Good evening, students. So in the last class, we have discussed about how the communication process has been done in your power system protection, that is your fiber optic relaying, and then we have moved on to your microwave relaying, and then we have seen what are the latest trends in your power system protection, such as VAMs. Okay. So now we have moved on to the last part of the topic, that is your application of your AI techniques to power system protection. So we are going to apply your artificial intelligence for your power system protection. Okay, so first we'll be seeing about your fuzzy logic technique, then we will move on to your artificial neural technique. Okay, so when I say it as a fuzzy logic, fuzzy means something which is not clear or vague. Now let us consider the digital system. So in Boolean system, when I say it as 1 or 0, 1 means true, 0 means false. It gives a very crisp value, absolute value it gives. Whereas fuzzy system deals, it is based on the degrees of truth. Okay, so that means, suppose, is it cold? If I say yes or no, means it is Boolean logic. I am saying exactly. Okay, whereas if I am going to say in terms of comparison, like if I am going to ask, suppose, what is the height of Suresh, for example? So in that case, if I am going to say he is taller than Ramesh or he is shorter than Vidya, so whatever it is, okay. So if I am going to just give with respect to the comparison, degrees of comparison, then it comes under your fuzzy logic. Okay. So in day-to-day life, everything we cannot say directly exactly. So certain things, we will say with respect to your degrees of comparison, wherein this logic comes into picture. Okay, that's what. Is it cold? If I am going to say, if it is very much, I can take it as 0.9. So it is little bit only I have cold. I have very less cold, which is a 0.1%. Okay. So when I'm going to take my fuzzy logic components, so first of all, whatever I'm going to give it to the fuzzy block to explain you, understand clearly, I'll just take the example of the washing machine. So what happens in the washing machine? So I know the amount of clothes I'm going to put today. So let us take the 10 clothes I'm going to put. Whatever I'm going to put, whatever the data I'm going to be provided by the consumer, it is going to be a crisp value. Okay, 10 clothes or 15 clothes. Now you're going to have a fuzzifier. Whatever the data I'm going to give, in case of protection, the data will be from the analog sensors, the data, current, voltage, all these data will be given to the fuzzifier. So what is this fuzzification done by this fuzzifier? So it will convert this crisp values into fuzzy sets. That is, whatever the data I'm going to convert, I will be giving 10 clothes and how much is the water drawn, all those things with respect to your washing machine. So whatever the data has been given, so just take the example of this cold, warm or hot. Okay, like let us take the temperature of the oil in the circuit breaker. It is cold, warm or hot. Depending upon that, it just divides into, because you will have your annunciator in your SCADA system, wherein you will just say, okay, if the threshold is going beyond the value, then it will, in case of your transformer, in case of book calls relay, if it is going to be a slow developing fault, it will give an alarm. If it is going to be farther, if the fault level is going to be very high, then it will it will trip the circuit, okay? So for the alarm condition, if the temperature of the oil goes beyond this, then it has to provide an alarm. Okay, only the ranges, okay? So just for the control system for processing, you can take any of the variables like temperature of the liquid or the pressure of the liquid or the RPM of the machine. Okay, so it is just going to give a, it is not going to give the crisp value, but it is going to give you the linguistic value. Okay, whether it is going to be cold, hot or warm, whatever it is. So once, depending upon this, so you will be framing a fuzzy rule based set, that is fuzzy rules. If the temperature is like the pressure is, I do this one. If then rules you are going to frame. Okay, so if the RPM goes below this level, then it should sound an alarm. So using the fuzzy rule base, you're going to incorporate the intelligent into the system. If this is the case, then accordingly, my relay should act like this. Based on this, based on the input condition, it is going to give your output. That is, based on this, intelligence is nothing but your inference engine. So based on the data, whatever you're giving, okay, for you'll be designing the rule base in this case. Okay. For example, you can take the pen also, like, so this set of pens belongs to 5 rupees, this set of pens belongs to 10 rupees. It can be of different make, from different company also. Okay, so the same way. So depending upon the rules, they are based on these inputs and what is the function it has to perform. Suppose if you take the power system. Okay, if the rule is that, okay, if the temperature is going to be the rule you are going to fix, if the temperature goes below a certain value, then it has to give the output. So the output what you get is also, you will get the oil is warm, the oil is cold, okay, like the fuzzy output you will get. Then this output, because at the output the customer needs only the crisp output, whether I have to on the alarm or off the alarm. In that case, so this fuzzy output is again, it is fed to a defuzzifier and you are going to get your crisp output. That's what, as I told you, so the rule base where you are going to use the if-then conditions, and based on that, okay, usually you will be using different types of function, trapezoidal function or your triangular functions. So based on that, if then rules, if and or rules, based on that you will be creating the rule base and you will be giving it to the inference engine. So this inference engine is an important part where it is going to match your fuzzy input to each rule and you will get your output. As I told you, the final stage, that is your defuzzification, wherein whatever the data sets obtained from your inference engine, again it will be converted to your crisp value. I think more than 10 different sets of defuzzifications are available. So which one is the best suited one? So that will be accordingly. So which this defuzzification rule you are going to choose, so that your error is going to be minimized and you are going to get the correct output with respect to your input. So that particular rule base will be taken. That is, that particular set rule will be taken and it will be displayed. So one such example is using your center of mass. Okay, another is centroid. So whichever gives a better value based on that. So just the mathematical functions will be used. Okay, based on that, or mean. One defuzzification is mean is there. So depending upon that, you will get the output. Now we will move on to your fuzzy logic system. So as we have seen, this fuzzy logic system is going to be an easier and understandable one. You can use it both for your commercial as well as for your practical purposes. So it helps you to control the machines, as we have seen the general example of your washing machine. And when you talk with respect to your power system, it is used for controlling your power system machines and helps in giving your outputs. Okay, it cannot give you accurate reasoning, but acceptable reasoning, whether I have to on the circuit breaker or off the circuit breaker. So it also gives a new path in which you say about the uncertainty in the engineering. You are not going to give the crisp values. Okay, so if at all the temperature is going to lie between 55 to 65 range, so in that case, 55 might be the starting point for the hydrogen bubbles to be evolved in case of your transformer, for example, say, okay. So in that case, you know, it gives a range. So whenever it's starting itself, it will alarm. It can be modified as per the designer's buffer. Designer can alter it as per his own logic. And see, according to me, like I can say that 55 degree might be the low temperature, okay. For other person, that might be the, okay, quite bit of higher temperature. So depending upon the buffer, depending upon the logic, so it is just gives a range. You cannot say 55 to 65, okay. I might say 55 is the highest temperature. Some might say 57 degrees Celsius might be the higher temperature. Okay, now we will move on to your disadvantages of fuzzy systems. So what is fuzzy systems? As I told you, it is not always accurate, but based on the assumptions, you can get your output. So it is not widely accepted. Furthermore, this when you go in for the disadvantages, this fuzzy system, it is don't have the capability of the machine learning and the neural network type pattern recognition. What do you mean by that? So when you say it as a neural network pattern recognition, so once I train my network, okay, neural network, you will have two types. One is supervised learning and another is unsupervised learning. So whatever the pattern you are going to give, the neural network will recognize and it will predict the same. Okay, so those capabilities you don't have in your fuzzy system. Okay, so whenever I want to validate the condition, because so whatever we are going to apply is a real-time situation. Okay, so this validation and verification of this fuzzy system, it requires extensive testing that you have to keep hardware and test it. So in that case, making this fuzzy rules and many membership functions, you have to hit them rules. So this, using that, you will be framing your membership functions. So this is going to be a very hectic task. Okay, now let us see what are the possible applications of the fuzzy systems in your power system. So mainly it is used for identification of the fault type, whether L2L fault or LG fault which are occurred in your transmission lines, and where is the exact location the fault has occurred, and it is also used for the differential protection of your power transformers. You can also use it for your relaying as well as non-relaying problems. If I want to use it for my voltage and speed control of my synchronous generators, or if I wanted to take all the diagnostic tests of the power transformer, whether it works properly or not. Finally, it can be used in the development, planning, and assessment of your power networks too, and also in your reactive power control and load forecasting. Okay, now we'll see how you are going to use your fuzzy approach for your overcurrent protection. So what are the main three components you are going to use is your analog filter and your A to D and your digital filter. And from here, you will choose what are the elements you are going to choose for your measurement. Okay, from the CTs and PTs, you will take all the data. It will be digitized because all the relays what we are going to use with your fuzzy are going to be your digital relays or your numeric relays. So these data will be given to your numerical relays. Okay, so based on this, you will be getting your data. So whatever it is, okay, all the data you will be getting. Either if I want to take the current parameter or your voltage parameter or line to line voltage parameter, whatever it is, all the data will be fed to your classification block, where the CRIBS data will be converted to your fuzzified data. And here you'll use your inference engine, where the data will be checked with your if-then rules, and final decision will be made. So based on the decision, CRIBS signal will be issued. So when I say it as a overcurrent protection, what will be the criteria? So it will be checking for the threshold value. If the current is going to go above your threshold value, then the relay will act upon the digital relay. Okay, so here some of the signals, what you can take it for your measurements, okay? So the signals, what you can take it for your measurements are, it can be the fundamental component of current. What do you mean by fundamental component of current? It is nothing but your 50 hertz current. Okay. So then what is the main problem? Harmonics will be injected in this circuit. So it is a cautious measure to check your second harmonic level. That means what is the current magnitude of the current at 100 hertz. Okay. So then you will take a ratio of I2 by I1. And if needed, you will take the line to line voltage. Okay, so whenever you are going to give it in the SCADA system or by using your digital relays, instead of BN, it would be specified as UN. So depending upon the magnitude of the currents that is noted, accordingly based on this fuzzified rules, so it is going to give your outputs. Okay, so between the range 0 to 1, whether it has to operate, it cannot give, okay, 0 or 1. So it gives the range, okay, 55 to 65 degrees. If it is reaching that degree, then it would operate. Or if the current magnitude falls between 5 amps to 8 amps, then the relay has to operate. So that range of output it gives. Now we will move on to your fuzzy logic based differential protection of your power transformer, okay. So in this, what you are going to do, you are going to take the data. What happens in your differential protection? You just measure the current from both the ends. Okay, but whenever I am going to use the data acquisition from this differential protection, I cannot use the data directly. Okay, I have to pre-process this data using the flux transform. Okay, so based on this, I have put a paper also. So here, where you will measure all the components, okay, whatever is the small variations in the components is del delta, del beta, and del gamma. All these data will be given to the fuzzy system, and of course, it will check if the data received is going to be greater than the threshold. Then it will check for all the three components. If that is the case, then if all the three cases are going to disobey, then you have to issue a trip signal. So else the signals will be, if no, the signals will be set window wise. That is, if you take one sample, it will be sampled some 15 times or 16 times or 32 times. So that is called as a window. So how many samples you are going to sample in one window, accordingly the data will be processed. Okay. Now, in this case, the main thing in your differential protection is that, so the transformer should differentiate between your magnetic inrush and internal faults. So the magnetic inrush, as you know, you have learned in your second unit, so the relay should not operate for your magnetic inrush, it should operate only for your internal faults. So already we have seen that you have put a magnetic inrush relay because this inrush is going to be caused mainly due to your second harmonic component, and where which the current will be usually greater than 6 to 7 times the normal current. Okay, so it should not recognize as a overloaded condition or a fault, and it should not trip the relay. Okay, so that's what it is given. The inputs are nothing but your currents. They are going to be taken as the input as del del, del B and del gamma. It is going to be given as a fuzzified output. Then at the output condition, so here at the end of the defuzzification, you can fix it at a constant value. That is, if the output of the fuzzy is going to be greater than the threshold of 5, then I can say from 0.5 to 1, in that case I can consider the range as 1, that so that range will be fixed as, and it is internal fault. If it is going to be between 0 to 0.4, then I can say that this is the value. Okay, so this is a magnetic inductor, do not operate the relay. So when you can also set the counter. Okay, so when it is going to exceed all the conditions, threshold condition, then it will send a tripwolt the thing to the circuit breaker. So it checks all the three inputs. So when it exceeds the threshold level 3, then it will send a trip signal to the circuit breaker. Okay, so with this I'll wind up the topic. So the next topic we'll see in the next session. Okay, thank you.